Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Dear men, dear MGTOW, kindly find in several parts this day a bit of information from a website form goingyourownway.com. This time it is about MGTOW awareness of the actual nature of women, part 1. We said MGTOW is about awareness. Awareness about the actual nature of women. Well, what is the actual nature of the modern woman? If a man from 50 years back took a time machine to today, got a glimpse and had a 5-minute conversation with women today, he would zip back in time. It not much of an argument to assert that women today are in steep decline. But the key questions are, how so and why? We all summarize the MGTOW awareness of the modern woman. Women are less feminine than they used to be. They have tattoos, they smoke, they drink often heavily, they use profanity. They exhibit more aggression, terribly unpleasant in women. They raise their voice, they are combative. She walks with her chin up in male body posture. When women are not feminine, men cannot develop deep attraction to them. Women lack basic traits we value. A popular MGTOW blog articulated a set of traits the modern woman needs, and they are nurturing, supportive, responsibility, respectfulness, honesty. Women may have had these once. Then along came feminism for more. See the great regression. Rather than be nurturing, a woman has regressed to the point she is repulsed by the weakness in her male partner. She cringes when she sees it, feels contempt towards the man, and attempts to vine swing to another man. A woman is hardly supportive. A woman will stick stubbornly to her plans and superimpose them over yours, because doing anything else would be submissive. The dreaded S word. They would rather scream and claw at you in the parking lot over trivia than show any sign of submission. Also called being reasonable and sometimes agreeing with the other person. She avoids responsibility because she has been taught all her life she is a princess and can externalize her problems at the hand of society or men. Rather than be respectful, she has a chip on her shoulder against men, a resentment that has been intentionally stirred up in her by feminists and a slanted media. A woman's opportunism has never made her the most honest. It just now. Women can justify their untruths by saying they felt threatened or engage in trickle truth, and ultimately play the victim. A growing number of blue pill men made that way by feminist social engineering usually give them a pass. Women learn they can get away with it. Men want an asset in a relationship, not a liability. Without these traits, women are simply substandard men who impose on us their own agenda. Women are fat. Men select women for genetic and physical fitness. Women select men for a variety of traits, including status. For this reason, it is even more important for women to be in shape. However, more women are obese than men. Men can always offer intelligence, status, money, and a steady, commanding presence. A woman's appearance is crucial, and increasingly women fail this basic standard. Women are defensive. Women have a chip on their shoulder. This makes them unwilling to be vulnerable, open, smile. They are on the defensive against men, because they have been taught to be that way. They will lash out at a BF for simply saying something the wrong way. Much of a woman's resentment against men arises out of her own failed sexual strategy, wherein she pursues men out of her league, who inevitably dump her. She blames men for this and not herself. Overcoming a woman's resentment of men is more trouble than it worth. Women are delusional. Women are delusional about their actual sexual market and relationship value. Because higher value men are willing to sleep with average women but not commit, the average woman mistakenly think they deserve a man of that kind. When no one does, she refuses to accept her actual SMV and mate assortively with a man of similar SMV. She will end up becoming the reclusive superhero known as the Cat Lady, or become a heroic single mom, or marry, be miserable, and always be pining for the alpha men she could never get. Women assume 80% of men are below average. But society and the twat echo chamber has always told her she beautiful. You can imagine the chaos this causes in the relationship marketplace. Feminism has primed women to fight with men. When women come into a relationship hearing horror stories about how men bully women, any imagined slight becomes a reason to fight. Her honor depends on wearing the pants in the relationship. Her idea of being a strong, Independent woman is not sacrifice on behalf of her man or her family. It is selfishly fighting for her own interests at the expense of others. The cock carousel yields damaged women. A woman is not the same after the cock carousel. She loses the ability to pair bond. She devalues any man who isn't alpha. She grows to resent and distrust men in general. She loses faith in love and only seeks to use men for her final life goal, having children in a socially acceptable vehicle of marriage. The relationship trauma of 100 pump and dumps has injured her psyche and personality permanently. For more, see The Broken Woman. Women want alphas, or enter a resentful relationship with an 80% are male. What we observe today is the cock carousel, where 20% of the men get the lion's share of the women. This is how it was in the past, pre-traditionalism. No surprise then that their behavior today is the same, because the Great Regression has regressed women to their jungle nature. From there, they develop alpha widow syndrome, forever pining over alpha males they cold and keep. They reset their expectations to that higher level of SMV in a man. Even average-looking chicks are trying to score with alphas or otherwise be avoiders. Though some settle for beta males or 80% RS, they are rarely happy about it. Once primed with a jungle instinct, women cannot shift back into viewing relationships with their neocortex and taking the long view of compatibility. It is all about tingles and 80% RS don't do it for her. Women typically resent their beta male life partners. Even when married, they yield to alphas and demonstrate alpha groupie behavior. By the time some women are ready for a sorted of mating, they are both damaged, see broken woman, and they cannot value the mate they want to spend the rest of their life with. Some relationship, don't get me wrong, an 80% are male can very much have a relationship or get married if he wants to, but fewer and fewer want to, for reasons mentioned. The modern regressed woman has a jungle mentality unconducive to relationships. The jungle mentality is a result of the regression to Paleolithic, pre-traditionalist instincts over traditional common sense. What this means is that a woman is processing her relationship world with her hindbrain, using hardwired instincts formed millennia ago. For all intents and purposes, she is still in the jungle as far as this region of the brain is concerned. This changes her mentality in many ways. Hostility towards a man's problems. In the wild, women had contempt for male weakness because it jeopardized their survival. So when the regressed modern woman sees a man lose a social interaction, or have a cold, or suffer the loss of one of his parents passing, she loses attraction for him. She may even develop contempt for him. She will often go looking for another man if the weakness is too much. The one thing she won't do is be there for him. Alpha worship and vine swinging. The modern woman is always ready to vine swing. That why you hear women today say, "I don't believe relationship should be about hard work. If it work, why bother?" They always have one foot out the door. 10 years hooked on alpha cock does not disappear overnight. The modern woman habituates the sexual strategy used. Unlike men, she cannot compartmentalize and move on with her life. She will flirt with alpha male she sees in the restaurant, your friends, God forbid your boss. It will simply happen and she will be unapologetic about it, or even acting on it. Her cheating will be justified on an amazing connection she felt with a guy. Any BS post hoc rationalization to justify the drug-like high of tingles that she refuses to stare down in her sexual prime and now has become an addiction. The need for tingles. The modern woman demands what she had in her 20s. Tingles. Even when married. This means she will constantly shit test you and make you jump through hoops. You will need to maintain the perception of female options. A regressed woman only wants a pre-selected man with options who is choosing her to satisfy her narcissism. You will need to use dread game in order to keep her off balance and thinking you might be leaving her. Only through these psychological games can a modern woman be convinced to remain in a relationship. A woman carousel or avoider behavior has altered her relationship approach permanently. It carries over into the relationship and creates massive headaches and unwanted behavior.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.